to watch. Can y'all hear me okay?
Yeah. Yeah.
To watch Bill Finley is so amazing. I mean, it's just, every time I see the film, and of course, first of all, to look at the film which stars my son Cole, as my son looks exactly like. So that's such a powerful thing to go that means, my God, there's my son on the screen. But to watch Bill, and to watch what he does, and how remarkable he is, and all, it's just, you know, to listen to what Jessica is just who was working about trying to develop, to get more of the writers that had SCAP involved in the film. And I had started out as an actor. I love movies. I wanted to be movie pictures. You know, people do that. But so Brian, you know, after hearing some stuff, chose me to write the songs for the movie. And I always said it's the most remarkably bad choice, because what he'd heard before was a lot of Carpenter stuff, a lot of Three Dog Night, and, you know, Three Dog Night was as edgy as I got. I mean, because I wrote a lot of, I've always said I spent my life writing codependent anthems. You know? So I relate to Winslow really, really well. You know? Deep romantic and all.
Well, actually, they were talking to you about doing being a band, correct? Or?
Well, first of all, writing the songs, and then at a certain point, you know, Brian said, you know what? You should be the family. You crawl around up in the rafters and all, and kind of sneaky and giggly and weird. And I said, I'm not scary. I mean, I'm sorry. I'm scary. But Swan was, you know, when we started talking about it, the idea of playing Swan was just, you know, I mean, the heart of the joy of playing Swan to me is not in the scenes that all that trust me and things that are so over the top, you know, like, but the bathtub scene is the bathtub scene is, you see two characters, you see what my little guy was like when, you know, it's sort of, you know, egomaniacal, you know, loaded on drugs and all, basically me in the 30s and my 30s and 40s. And then you see this over the top, you know, evil character who is so charming and all. So to be able to play, you know, play those two elements, that's my favorite thing. For me to sit and watch the film, that's one of the great joys of watching the picture. This is that. And the other, I have to say that I've got here in time to see. I walked in and I was kissing Jessica, and I was like, wow. And I'm sitting next to my beautiful wife, Mariana, is in the audience, and all that stuff. And here it is, 40 years later, whatever it is, and I'm still kissing a really beautiful woman right now. Aww. So, but I have to say that to me, the heart of the movie is in a line that we just saw. And that's an incident which has a mistake in it, which I never caught until tonight. When I look down at Philbin and I say, he says, why do you want to kill somebody? And I say, remember when Philbin, I'm talking to Philbin now. Yes, when Philbin said whatever, to fire whatever, blah, 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 the line is, but then Philbin asked me, why would you have me have somebody killed in public like that? And I say, an assassination live on Coast to Coast Television. That is the essence of what to me the heart of the movie is that he caught on to something that is in fact, I mean, look at our world today, it is terrifying. And of course, from screaming at the television, son of a bitch, don't you love what you're doing? It's crazy, but